Good afternoon. Not good evening. It's 5 o'clock nearly. Look, got the door open. It's not dark and it's not cold. This will be probably a really quick video because all I'm doing tonight is going to go help for leather at the base plate. I haven't touched you for a little while. I've had things to do. We did the Dragon Rally. There may be a video for that, but it's a bit hit and miss because we got really drunk. We didn't mean to get really drunk, but we were stuck in the middle of Storm Eric and there was tents blowing away and chaos and mud. It was a lot of fun, but also we got very drunk. So there may be a short video for that to fill in the gap between not doing the Beetle and cracking on with it now. So as I said, it's going to be a really short video, this one, because all I've got to do is go hell for leather with a grinder and try and take off the rest of the remaining bits of base plate. Then we can get on with some proper sort of fabrication work and some bending of steel and a bit of welding. Don't really want to have to hammer at this any longer than I have to. So with that in mind, I will crack on. If I make any sort of progress, I'll show you. There won't be much video. It will be me just talking and maybe some photos. You'll have to manage with that. Send some new shots. So yeah, thank you very much. Keep watching. Let's get on and get the Beetle done. It seems like an age since I've touched it, and this is probably the most frustrating bit of it because it's the most heavy duty bit of metal and the hardest thing to remove. So thanks for watching and keep watching. So I've managed to remove now the piece that was there. It's on the floor here. You can sort of, that goes that way there. Is it that way? That way, sorry. That took a bit of getting off. You can see I've managed to clean this up a little bit. There was a remnant of spot welds. Like I said before, the Volkswagen spotlights are butch, like a really butch. So the next bit is going to be clean this up, all this old welding, carefully so I don't cut into the lovely shiny Volkswagen floor pan. Do the same here, cut this back. Ow! Okay, sharp, I swore. Sorry. Yeah, cut this back. So, I'm going to apologise for Whitney Houston, but I haven't got time to turn the radio off. So if I break into song, you'll have to forgive me. What I've discovered is, when I did this side, you can see where the spot welds were, and I sort of drilled them out with the spot weld drill, which works, but it's slow, and this is the spotlight weld drill. It's essentially goosed, to say, for want of another better word. So when I came to do the bottom piece, what I started to do was cut them. Because you can see a distinct line, when you put the camera in the right place, between the piece of metal here, which is by my fingernails, that I'm trying to remove, and the original piece underneath that I want to leave alone. What I've been doing very, very gently is just using the edge of this cutting disc, and there you can see, to slice either side of the spot weld. So for instance, there was a spot weld here. So what I've done is sliced here and here and the other side here. The steel in between just drops away because the spot welds are only few and far between. It's only thin. So if I cut here and here, this piece came out, then this piece, and then I've cut either side of the spot weld, and the whole thing just falls away. So I don't know if it's any use to anybody else, but it seems a sort of, especially on a piece like this, an easier way of getting them removed, and to be honest, a little bit clearer as well. So I shall crack on and show you. So, there we go. I've said erm again, sorry for the erms. I've removed all the old plate. I wasn't going to, but I decided it might be a better idea if I'm gonna do it right. I've cut a piece out here. It was rotten. I've got a piece to repair there, a repair there, a little repair there. Great dirty, great big chunk to put back in here to replicate that. The same again down here. I'd probably put a blob of weld in that, just need to clean this little noggin up there that I've missed. But the rest of it is still pretty solid. So do them again. Looks kind of disease. But it's 7:30. I'm going to go in. Tony Blackburn is on the radio now, and it's Friday night, so the Grand Tour is on. I've had to put a plate in there. It's not the neatest one I've done. It was the same as this piece up here. I think the damp may have gotten to my welding wire. I've welded the front the same as I did the other one. The hole wasn't quite as big, but it obviously needed doing, so I did that really quickly. I'm kind of pleased with how quickly I did it, although it looks a little bit messy. I haven't cleaned any of the welding up or anything. So what I'm going to do now, before I sign off for the evening, is clag some of this Hydrate 80 by Bilthammer. I believe it to be a pretty good rust converter. All the bits up here already, they're pretty clean already inside. I'm going to just paste them in this stuff. If I need to weld it, I'll just cut it back off again, rub it off with a wire brush. I need to make sure that there isn't any sort of, you know, rust in there. Once this is sealed up, I'll fill it with cavity wax and whatever else I decide to make sure that it doesn't rust anymore. There's some conveniently placed holes, I believe. Are they holes? They might not be holes, isn't it? That's where the original spot welds are there. But I may drill a couple of holes or find a couple of places that I can get in there with a spray gun. So anyway, I shall crack on and tidy this up a bit. Okay, so hello again. I have finished for this evening. I've just done, like I said, I'll see if I can show you. You see, it's got a sort of charming neon-y blue colour. That's the Bilthammer stuff doing its job. I will have to rub some of that back off again, but it is sitting in a sort of relatively humid environment in England, so the bit I've just cleaned up, I don't want it to rust. And there's some of the time there's no rust in there already, but I don't want any rust, so I imagine putting a rust converter on it won't do any harm at all. So I'm done. I've done my little patch on the front. I've got all the old base plate off, which was the one thing that was, excuse the light, it's gone mental. It constantly goes on and off. I think it might be said possessed by the devil, so maybe I won't see tomorrow. But yeah, so I'm pretty pleased for today, because I didn't... The one bit of the job was removing all the old spot welds. They're all sort of heavy-duty metal, and it's not like bodywork, which is thin and go, you can cut through that with a spoon. So yeah, I'm done for this evening. I want to just say a quick thank you again to Baby Sheep for these. He didn't buy them, he made me buy them. And also, if I can bear with me just 1 second. These also... I wasn't wearing them, and I was very blasé, and I sort of bought them as a sort of, look, Baby Sheep, I bought the protection stuff you keep telling me to wear. Well, this evening they paid off. This isn't the pair I was wearing, it's another pair. As I was cutting some metal, a little bit flew off. It managed to get under my glasses. You can just see it there. Could grade my face there. And you just about see it. I have no doubt if I hadn't been wearing these, it may have caught my eyes. Maybe next time I won't be so blasé about wearing the protective gear. And Tony Blackburn's on, and these muffle him quite well. So yeah, thank you for watching. Apologies for the lack of videos. Keep watching. There will be more that will come quicker, hopefully, now, as I'm cracking on a little bit again. And be excellent to each other. Thank you, and have a good evening.